Okay, I'm gonna get down to the nitty-gritty. This is I know this video is a bit long-winded, but you know what, I don't really care. I can edit it, I can do whatever I like. There's a question: are my findings correct? Now I have to ask myself, do I trust my equipment? Years ago, when I was, as I say, earlier on in electronics, I had just about the best of everything. You know, in the day, back in the day, all of these meters would be Fluke, which were the best at the time, and you know, the oscilloscopes and bench power supplies were Farnell and stuff like that. Nowadays, if it cost me more than £8, that's £8, I don't bother. I just buy cheap stuff, and it does for what I want, you know. Today, now, there's only a couple of these things that I actually trust. That one wasn't a lot of money. I think it was about £20 or something like that. It does most of what you want. It's even got a frequency counter on it. You've got the usual DC, AC volts, resistance, capacitance, all sorts of stuff. And I do trust that meter. The other one I trust is this, which is an LCR meter. And I use that primarily for, obviously I'm going to be using it for capacitance soon, but it doesn't read very high. 2000 microfarads. Okay, but I use that for inductance, obviously for the induction heaters. This one, I just use that for anything really, so, and these others. That is a dedicated capacitance meter. I don't really know what it goes up to. But do you trust your equipment? So what I did, I changed all the batteries, as I said. This one, let's see. range. Nanofarads. Okay, we've got a 330N cap. Let's see what that meter says. And it's telling me that it's 338. Which isn't bad. That's not bad. Now, if I go to what I call my trusty meter, and select capacitance. Now I know I shouldn't hold the leads because I am a capacitor. What we'll do, we'll twist the leads like so, and we'll get a measurement. Now that's saying, that's reporting 323, which again isn't bad. It's 330, so it's saying 323. The other meter that which I do trust is this one, my LCR meter. Let's see, turn him on, and that's saying 327. So they all fairly much agree. That one I trust, that one I trust. I suppose really I should trust this one, but it's you know, that one cost about £8, I think, or something like that. Now, do you trust your equipment? This is why I'm doing this. That is a piece of composite material which I made. Very plasticky. And it's got some of my flake in it. And all I did was I mixed up some polystyrene or styrofoam with acetone. I took the goo out of the pot. I kneaded it until it wasn't quite as sticky. And I put some of that flake in it. And I measured the resistance. And, well, the results were as I'm going to show you now. What we'll do first, can't even see this. Okay, conductivity. It's going to be a bit hit and miss. I made that in 5 minutes, just with my hands, and just molded it with my hands. So it wasn't very scientific, but I mean, it does work. It is conductive. Okay, that's my little battery. Can you see that? I don't know. Okay, sturdy tripod. Right, that's my little cell. That's the dual thief LEDs, and this. So if we take off the positive supply, do that, touch it on the terminal, it don't work. Going on there. What have I done? Okay. Oh, that's better. Okay. As I say, it's hit and miss, but you're going to find dead spots in it, I suppose. But look, very conductive. So that's that. Now, we can go back to where we were and try and find my thread again. Oh yeah, do you trust your equipment? I do trust this one. It's, for the money, it's fantastic, really. As I say, conductive. Now, if we change it to resistance, let's try this at 50 mil. We get 6.8 ohms. If I go 1 centimeter, ohms. Eight ohms. I've had much lower readings than that from this stuff. 9 ohms. I'm going to have to get me one of those blocks that Robert uses all the time. There we go. 4 point something. So the material's got a fairly low resistance. I'll turn it over. This side's a bit more polished, and it's going to call me a liar. Okay, when it settles down, all right, 6.4, 4.6. Now, do you trust your equipment? This meter is about, that's getting on a bit now. That was ridiculously cheap. Can you see that? Yes, you can. Let's try that one, see what that says. ohms at 1 centimeter. I'll try and get this so you can see that it's a centimetre. This isn't Hollywood, folks, so don't expect too much. Okay. 10 ohms. That's a bad spot, obviously. Try and find a better spot. 9.2. So you're getting around about the 10 ohms mark there on that side. So that's that one. Now, the meter that I do trust is this one. 200 ohms, because that's as low as it will go. And let's just do it this way. Okay, about the same reading. I'm not doing too bad today with these meters. Okay, 6.1. Turn it over. That's strange, you know, that that shiny side, or the polished side as I call it, seems to seems to be worse than the unpolished side. Now go again. Right, one more on that side. About 10 ohms. Now the unpolished side, which seems to be the better side. Ah yeah, of course it's a composite material. We're probably where we've polished it, measuring, trying to measure plastic or composite plastic. So that's that side. Okay, so as I say, I trust that meter. Don't trust that one. Definitely trust that one, because I've used that a lot. I use them all a fair amount, but I use that one more than anything else. Now, do you trust your equipment? I'm sorry to keep going on about this, but you've got to try and be a little bit scientific, and you've got to try and prove your findings. So we've now got 4 meters all set to 200 ohms on the resistance. That one's auto ranging, so that does what it likes. What am I going to do? Let's try. Okay, I've got a known resistance there, 10 ohms. Okay, which one have we got? The really, really, really cheap one. And we're going to measure this resistor. What you find with these cheap meters is when you get to lower resistances, they don't like it. So that's telling me that that's about 12 ohms. Now, we know it's 10. Okay, it's still telling me it's 12 ohms. This one. that's even worse, it's telling me it's 15. Now, the one I trust. And my other trusty meter, which I do trust, as I keep saying, keep repeating, there is a reason for that. You need to trust your findings. So we've got okay, 10.1, so they kind of agree. What I should do, I guess, really, is try something like a 1k resistor and these other not so good meters, they tend to get better. So we'll try this one again. The 1k resistor, there is a reason for doing all of this. Okay, almost 1k. The next one, on the 2k scale, I think we can agree that's reporting 1k, and we know the other two will report 1k, so on the higher resistances they all tend to agree. When you get lower down, the better ones tend to be correct and the not so good ones tend to be absolutely rubbish. Now that was 10R, we know what they did with 10 ohms. Here I've got a bag of 1R resistors, 1 ohm resistors, and I use them for a dummy load not so long back. But let's start at the beginning with this one. This is 1 ohm. Okay, so I won't expect too much here. Turn it back to the 200 scale before I forget. Now that's telling me that that's 2.7, so it's wildly incorrect. This one, next resistor, that's even worse. And I'm just going to repeat this with the meters so you know. Right, okay, so I think on the lower readings we can discount that, because if I go to this material, what will it say? And there we go again, 2.4. now if I go to a meter that I trust, yeah, or even first, let's just go through the motions. That meter there, that's even worse, 7.3. okay, now this is just to prove a point. That one, let's see if my trusty meter, or one of them, works. This is about a centimeter. You see, now I trust that. That's 0.6. Or is it, hold on, is it 6 ohms? You know, I don't know whether that's 0.6 or 6, but I think it's 0.6. Anyway, as I say, it's early Sunday morning, I haven't slept, hardly. Now, this one, oh, can we still see that? Yes, we can. Let's see what that one says. 0.4. So that was 0.6. So at least I know what the segment is. That's 0.6, 0.4 on this material. Now, we know at the lower readings these don't work. We know that. So what I'm going to do for the rest of this is get rid of that one because it don't work. Definitely get rid of that one because that definitely doesn't work. And this is where we get down to what I was saying earlier on, where you need to trust the equipment. So here we go. We'll leave that on, leave that on. As I say, they're all new batteries in all of these. Shut up. That's the only thing I don't like about this one. It keeps going on. Just moans a lot. So, you saw the resistance of that flake, which is what I'm going on about today. Molded into a composite material very, very quickly. I've just kneaded it like you would knead dough. Kept folding it and scrunching it up and ended up with that. And it's really, I'm flabbergasted, because even at sort of 10 ohms or 15 ohms, you know, it's quite surprising. I've had as little as 4 ohms on a, you know, out of this, but it's going to be hit and miss. Whereas these, different story. That's the same material on. It's too thick. I mean, that's the whole point of this, is that I get that, you know, nice, so many microns film on some other material, and if it performs as well as it does like this, then, you know, I'll be a happy chappy, and I'll be glad to share it with everyone else, and, you know, tell you how I achieved it, or how I think I achieved it. And it's either going to be me, as I said, or it's going to be the base product is superb. So it's one or the other, isn't it? So we've got a piece of aluminium, which went slightly wrong, but a piece of copper, so PCB, same material, and a piece of zinc with the same material. It's very, very soft because it's so thick. You can keep on polishing it, but you'll be there forever. What I'll do, I will give that a quick polish now. And you can scratch it quite easily. Looks like a skate ring. So, quick polish. There's still a lot of base graphite coming out there, but I don't care about that. Right. So, I'm guessing that, this particular meter, although we don't trust it, it's good for something. Hope you can hear that. Conductivity. That's on the material. That's on the zinc. That is zinc to the material. Aluminium. Aluminium to the material. Copper to the material, copper, aluminium, and the other one, Oh, that's conductive, isn't it? Okay, just press a bit. As I say, that's not a scientific way of making something. I'll have another go at that with the other stuff. I mean, I'm going to make some sodium silicate. We'll try that and lots of other stuff. So yeah, this one, let's just set that to conductivity, or maybe not. Yeah, okay, so this, that composite material, okay, so that's that. I mean, it's bonded fairly well, considering I used like an epoxy. It was very, very thin. I just scraped it on so thin, and I obviously compressed the material into the epoxy to get conduction between the two materials. But okay, so now we're back to reading the resistance at the risk of repeating myself over and over again. Straight away we've got 6 ohms, so I love that. This one we've got 0.4. This one, .5. And this last one we've got 0.4. So the 2 meters that I trust .6. .7. .6. All at 1 centimeter. So yeah. Now interestingly enough, that's a reading 2.3 ohms from the material to the aluminium. Let's try them all, shall we? I forgot to try this bit, as you do. That one is reading from the material to the zinc. Fold that tab up because it's getting awkward. Okay, try there. 0.8. So we've got good conduction between the two materials there. Try it a bit closer. Okay, 1 ohm, not so good there. 0.7 of an ohm. That's the zinc. Aluminium, I have to do this two-handed. Aluminium on the material. 2 ohms. 2 ohms. So we haven't got such a good result there. Probably because I didn't press hard enough, or there may be too much epoxy or whatever. But let's try it again. Do you know what? I'm hungry. And I'm going to get into trouble if I don't hurry up. Okay. .5 and the copper. .6. So obviously the aluminium, the one which went, I'll say went wrong, is the worst one, and the other two are pretty good. So the flake itself is really awkward because it breaks up because of the process that I did, which I'll explain a bit more about at the end. The flakes are very brittle, and to find a piece at 1 centimeter initially is hard work, and then secondly, as you're testing it, it breaks very easily, so it's really fine. So let's just do, we'll try the same test again on the flake itself and hope that we get a result, because this, if I do get a result, what's going on here, if I do get a result, then it's quite good. There you go, a piece that's about 1 centimeter, 0.4 of an ohm. And again, second trusted meter, hope that this flake doesn't break. Didn't quite agree. 0.6, 0.7 of 1 ohm. 0.6. I'll settle for that. So there you go. That's this stuff. My new flake. Now, let's just get down to the bit where I think I've performed some magic. Now, I could be wrong. If there's anyone out there that's even bothered to watch this to the end, because it's quite long, I might have to break it up into sections. If you're watching this and you're following it, there is a section on YouTube where you can comment, and I'd like you to comment if you will. Don't turn into a keyboard warrior or a troll. You know, if you can spot that there's something that I've missed, something I haven't done, something I've done wrong, please message me. And if I have done something wrong, then you know, I'll just go back to basics and start again. I don't mind that, that's what it's all about. But at the moment, that material is showing an extremely low resistance, and this is why I was up half the night. I've emptied the fridge of beer, which I shouldn't have done, and you know, keep leaving stuff like this around, which isn't professional, but I don't care. So yeah, you know, comment. Now I'll just run through what I did. I took some intercalated graphite, I put it in the microwave as you do, and turned it into expanded graphite. Now a lot of people do that all the time. I think my favorite is Pete in Australia, better known as A, and as I like to call him, Mad Pete, because we're all a bit mad, all of us. Gotta be to dedicate so much time to this stuff. But anyway, he then puts his expanded graphite in a book, big thick book, puts it under his car tyre or wheel and drives over it a few times. Then he opens the book, he spreads, puts another layer on and does and repeats that to get the foil, graph oil as he calls it, into a usable thickness of material that doesn't break. Now I did that with this material, and my method, because it's not as warm as in Australia, in the UK, I decided to stay indoors. So I put some in a piece of paper like that. I'm just going to do this, go over this very quickly, because it's getting late and it's taking too long. I'm talking too much. So you can go in the kitchen and borrow grandma's rolling pin, give it a good roll. Let's get some of this out of the way. Okay, so there you've got your material, and it's very, very flimsy. So you go again. And you end up with a thicker material like that. It was at that stage where I thought to myself, how many times can you expand that graphite? So what I did to get this material, I took that, I chopped it up in the blender, and I put it back in the microwave, and I got the usual worms. And I did the same process. I rolled it a couple of layers, and obviously thought to myself again, can I expand it again? So I tried it, and it worked. Again, I chopped it all up fine, put it back in the microwave. And on the third occasion, I noticed that the worms were quite thin, quite small compared to those. And you could physically see it with your eyes, or at least I hope I could. So on the third occasion, I did the same again. But on the third occasion, what you could not do, and then you can see the way that clumps together as you roll it, you know, it just sort of forms onto the next piece. But this stuff, not that one, this stuff, this is really scientific, isn't it, eh? Proper lab this. If you get those flakes and you roll those, make sure we give them a good roll. What I'll do when my microwave arrives, along with my sonicator, I'm going to run through on the camera, on the bench, exactly what I did, and show the actual process, as opposed to just talking about it. Now that material, you cannot, it will not clump together. It just won't. Okay, it just will. It doesn't matter how many times you roll it, it does not clump together. So all I can see is that we've got something different there to the start of the process, at, I don't know, an atomic level or whatever. I just don't know. What I'm going to try and do is design a process where I can get that material really, really thin, you know, onto a piece of metal or whatever material really, and get it bonded and use it, because it's, well, you've seen the readings. And I'll just quickly show you what I mean. Again, we'll take that, which has been expanded once, we know that. I'm glad that induction heater works as well. I think I'll get a crucible and or even use one of these with a bigger coil and start using my induction heater to do the job. Anyhow, here we go. So that's your material. Now you can, what you can do, you can feel that there's a massive difference between that and that on the surface. Now the other thing is, if I take that, I don't know if this is going to work, but it is leaving that normal graphite trace. Now, hopefully you can see that's a bit cleaner. If I take this material, try and do the same thing. Oh, it's left the trace. Didn't expect that. I must have mixed a bit up, because I did that yesterday and it definitely would not leave a trace on my hand at all. No matter how much you rubbed it, not leave a trace. So that's another thing I'll show when I do a separate video of the process. But anyway, what I was trying to say was this stuff will, no matter what you do, how many layers you put on, it will clump back together. And you can put some more on the top and it'll all clump together. You can fold it as many times as you like. There's a completely different feel to that compared to that other flake, which I think I've mixed up. Aye aye. Battery low again. This must be a long one. So there you go. That's what I did. You've seen the results. If you've got anything to say, please say it. I don't mind. Positive or negative, pardon the pun, I don't mind. Just, you know, don't be silly and start ranting and raving at me. Just talk to me. If I've got something, I've shared it. If I haven't, I'm going to feel like an idiot for a couple of days, but hey ho, such is life. So anyway, I'll, in the next couple of days, I'll do the next part of the video, hopefully with a microwave, and show you exactly what I did and how I achieved the results on that material. I'm tired, I don't know about you. If you've got this far, then great. If you didn't bother to watch, fine. But if you've got this far and you fancy talking about it, to me, or I was nearly mixed that up again then, look. Yeah, go ahead, let's have a chat. But that, you know, you just struggle to believe it, really. But unless there's someone else out there that's got the same results already, I don't know. It's slow to read that because it's such a low resistance, and it's making the meter think. 0.4. A known resistance of 1 ohm. .1 ohms. So there you go. I'm gonna have a quick cup of coffee and grab something to eat, hopefully, providing she's not too mad at me. Thanks for watching.